Take three. I'm trying to do a short video, but I keep going off on tangents. Condor DM had something to say, something I've been talking about.
Here is a question. If you're playing a wizard, do you have to be intelligent in real life? You know, if you're not that intelligent, should you avoid playing a wizard? Well, you may have heard from some people that you have to be really intelligent to play a wizard. Well, I am here to tell you that they are wrong. You can be of average intelligence and play a wizard that you portray as intelligent.
See, this is good advice. When I was a kid, I remember being told, "Oh, you have to be smart to play a wizard." And then someone says, "No, the character has to be smart to be a wizard." This is when you're making a character. You have to roll some high intelligence of something, some sort, so that you can then decide if your character is going to be a wizard. I think that's how it works. If you didn't have the stats for it, you couldn't be a mage. And then this video reminded me of Traveler, where you're rolling up characters and you end up with these old guys. You're role playing these old dudes, but you're a kid. I had no idea how to role play some old dude who's retired and everything. I didn't have any references for that from movies. I mean, I hadn't seen Alien yet. Alien had old people in it. But the thing about you have to be smart to role play a smart character. What do I say to that? I don't know the word for it. I'm against it. Your character is going to be the one worrying about their intelligence, not the player. The player can be as dumb as a rock, but they've got this character that's super smart. Because when they do the die roll is when you see the character doing their smart stuff. If the let's say the player doesn't know, let's say the player's doing a science character in Traveler, and they want to, the character's trying to find a cure for some virus. Now the player isn't a doctor, they're not a scientist in real life. They don't even know how to role play one, probably. But they can at least the player can at least say things like, my character's in the sick bay and he's doing some sort of formulas and doing some tests, seeing if his serum will cure the virus or not." And the player will say also what equipment they have, because that will usually add a modifier. And then they make their roll. And they're a scientist character. The scientist probably has scientific skills, so they have a chance of succeeding, even though the player doesn't know anything about science. The other thing is the Condor mentions about the fighter in Traveler. You could have a guy who's a gun nut, He's this gun nut in real life. He does the gun stuff. He does the firing range. He knows all about weapons. For whatever reason, he's role playing a character who has no gun fight skills. None. Zero. How is he going to role play his character? Because the character is not going to know anything about guns. So he's gonna have to role play his character differently, or just because when he makes a roll, it's gonna fail, right? When when his character's shooting guns, or let's say you have like a super smart person in the room, and they're role playing an imbecile character. They're just gonna it's just gonna be the character's role, the characteristic roles that are gonna determine outcomes for that, for the imbecile character, right? Or if you have an imbecile player, and they're playing some super, super smart, super science genius character. They don't have to act smart. They don't have to try to think smart. It all. What I'm trying to say in this video is it just comes down to your die rolls. You know, your skill checks based on your characteristics and your skills. That's the die roll determines what your character is, because it looks retarded. I've seen this so many times when a player wants to do a speech. I've used this example many times. The player wants to give a speech with his character to a mass crowd up on stage, a podium, his politician character. He does this perfect speech as a player in the game, which I think is weird. And it's like, it's not going to matter. I'm thinking to myself, this isn't going to matter because it all comes to a roll. Now, some GMs will just give it to the player. Oh, that was a great speech. That was a heartfelt speech. And then they just give it to the... They let the character get away with that? Without a roll? I always say, no, we're going to roll for this. I thought this was a game, so we're going to roll. So after the player does their arousing speech, apparently, then they do the roll and it fails. Now what do you do? What do you do? So that's why I don't have players doing that kind of stuff in the game. The player just simply says, I walk up, you know, I step up to the podium, I do a little mic check thing, you know. testing. And you have feedback. I always make the feedback sound, you know, when they first talk into a microphone. A bit hot. And then the player says, I proceed to give my speech, talking about how the two planets should stop fighting each other. And I look at this group, and I look at this group as I'm speaking. And then you roll. You roll to see how the audience reacts to your speech you just gave without saying the speech. Same with the scientist doing the brain surgery. They don't have to explain how they're doing the brain surgery, you know. Nurse. I need clamps. I need scalpel. You know, all those old 50s and 60s shows, right? You don't have to do all that. Just say that you're doing the brain surgery thing. And you usually tell the person running the game how much time you want to take doing this. Because the longer you take to do it, the more successful you'll be at doing it. If you're in a rush and you say, I don't have time to do this brain surgery, but I'll just poke around in there real quick and take a look-see. Maybe I can fix his brain in like 10 minutes. That's crazy talk. You know, you're reducing the time needed to do brain surgery just because you're in a hurry, you know. So that's a minus to your role right there. It's kind of cool if the character gets away with it, because maybe the character is super, super good at brain surgery, so they don't need to take an hour or two to do it. But again, the player doesn't have to explain the procedure for doing brain surgery. The player is not going to know how to do brain surgery. And let's say the player is a brain surgeon or a heart surgeon, and they're at the table, and they got this character who's just the worst at medic skills. That player should not expect their character to just do what they do. It's not them that's in the game. It's the character that's in the game. If the character has no medic skill, that's a -3 to the role. So that expert heart surgeon should get used to the idea that his character can't do heart surgery on anyone. Will never be able to. Can't even do first aid. That's what the die rolls are for. There's always... skill checks are there to make sure the players aren't just prancing around the game doing whatever they feel like doing. No, there's skill checks. Just like there's sobriety checks that the police do on the roads. That kind of, there's metal detectors at airports. There's, you're getting checked by somebody. You don't just go prancing through on your way nonchalant. I mean, you could, as a character, you could do that, but not as a player. Players don't get to just do the things. There's a skill check. Roll to see if you do that. 'Cause I hate it. I hate it when I watch a actual play and I see players saying stuff like, I use my sword and I cut the guy's head off. And then they roll to see if that happened or not. What is that about? Or I steal the purse from the lady. Okay, roll to see if you do that. Or I steal the necklace she's wearing. Okay, let's roll to see if you did that. Or my horse is able to jump this fence and I'm now in the secret garden. Okay, let's see if you were able to do that. Did you just go into the secret garden without going through the secret gate? Yeah, you gotta roll to see if your horse even did that or not. Otherwise, players just are doing everything. Right? There's no checks and balance. That's what the skill checks are for. Anyway, I gotta go eat pizza.